What's up, everybody? Doing some more Blender. You saw my last video, you saw the wave animation. Open that for you. So, walk through how I got that set up. Back to this file is just the mesh with the armature. Object mode, select our armature, go into edit mode, and we're going to set up these two IK bones. We're going to set up on the right hand side. So we just select this tail, extrude Y axis, make us a little handle, clear the parent, Alt P, turn on my screencast, and let's get rid of this. Alright, so then we're going to make another one for the elbow. E for extrude, Y for the Y axis. Then we're going to clear this parent. And we'll just get a side view so I can line it up with this other one. G, Y. Line them up like that. So then to set up the inverse kinematics, like I have here, so if we go to pose mode, you can see I just grabbed this handle on the wrist, and then I can manipulate the whole arm with just that one handle. Then this is for the elbow, so as you see, as I move this, the elbow follows it. So let's go back to edit mode. 3 for side view, 9 for the opposite side. Select our handle. Actually, we want to select the forearm. That's bone 21. So then we go to pose mode. Should we have our forearm selected? Add bone constraint, inverse kinematics, armature, and bone 21 is this handle on the wrist right here. Make the chain length 2 because we want these two bones to follow this handle. So 1, 2, one for the forearm, one for the bicep. Then our pull target is going to go to the armature, and it's going to be bone 22 because we made it after this. And we made this one was 21, and then we made this one make that 22. So now you can see the elbow is pointing weirdly. So, not that. Alright, negative 90 is pretty close. So the pull angle determines how this setup is aimed at this constrained bone right here. So again, just like the other side, if I move this, the elbow moves to follow it. Just like on this side. So with that, I can One for front view. No, no, no. One for front view. So if I put this hand up in the air, I can move this to turn the arm. Yeah, I can make it like he's hanging off of a ladder or a ledge or getting something off of a shelf while he's talking to his brother. So that's what the elbow bone does. These are the pull targets for your elbow joints. So that's what the bones do. And this little handle for the wrist. Put back in the original position. Actually, I'll go ahead and do my standing pose. Then we're going to do the same thing for the knees and the ankles. So go into edit mode. E for extrude, Y to pull it straight out the back. Clear parent. We do the same thing on the other side. And you can rename these bones. If you go over here to the properties panel, click on your bone name. This would be legik.l. Use capital L. And this would be legik.r. Then we're going to make pull targets for the knees. EY, bring it out the front. EY. And then we'll do the same thing. We'll just call this knee.l. And we'll call this one knee.r. There is a way, Blender does have a function for if you, so if I name all of these bones with a .l, so be thigh.l, shin.l, foot.l, bicep.l, forearm.l, hand.l, and then Blender will flip the names, but every time I try to do it, it acts all funny. So I would just name them manually for now. But we have those. Let's grab these. Side view. I did not clear the parent. Let's go ahead and clear the parent on this one. Select the guy. Side view. Let's just grab, pull them out front of the knee. We're gonna give our knees just a little bit of bend, like that. Then we go back to pose mode. We're gonna select our. I'm going to select our shin.r. Let's actually go ahead and rename these. You know what, it doesn't matter because we're selecting them anyway. So we just select that one, add constraint, inverse kinematics. And we want our legik.r to be the target bone. You see it's down here at the bottom because it's one of the last ones we made. And we're going to make the chain length 2, because again we have two bones, the shin and the thigh, just like the arm had the forearm and the bicep. So now, before we set up the pole target, let's give this a shot. So now you can see it moves the whole leg with just a handle. And the Blender's automatic wake painting does fairly well for messing around with the animations. You can see it distorts, transforms the body and everything. As I move the leg, it deforms other parts of the body. Excuse me. So we're going to do the same thing on this side. Select our shin, add constraint, inverse kinematics, armature, go down to our leg IK.L, make the chain length 2, and let's give it a whirl. I thought I hit G. Did I not clear the parent? So what seems to be the problem with that? I cleared the parent. And we're back into pose mode. Now let's try it. There we go. Yep, gotta make sure you clear the parents when you make your bones. So now we'll set up our pole target. So again, it's the target of this bone that's really in the middle of the chain. It's between the foot and the thigh. We want the knee to follow this bone here. So we're going to make the pole target knee.L. You can see it's turned some. So we'll try 90 degrees. That looks pretty good. Then if we move this, yeah, that looks pretty daggone good. Alt-G to reset it to the original position. Same thing on this leg. Armature. Knee.R. And we will make the pole angle 90. Alright. And just give it a shot to make sure it's not moving the other leg as well. It is not. So now, like I said, what I want to do is essentially have animate the motions of him turning around and then giving like a come hither wave, follow me type of wave, right this way. So if you watch my last video, you know one of the coolest things about animating in Blender are these IK setups. So all I have to do to animate this leg is basically grab this handle, move it to adjust the leg position, and then we're using pose to pose animation. So I have a beginning pose, which would be him standing. So I would make, again, select all of the bones, I for insert keyframe, and lock all of the data for all of the bones. So this locks the location, rotation, and scaling properties of every bone in the scene as a starting point for the animation. So then I grab my handle. He's going to turn to the right. Whoops. So he's just going to lift his foot up a little bit. He would be turning his leg, messed up, because the first thing you need to do to animate is decide what keyframe you want to insert the next set of data on. So first go to the keyframe you want to be on. So if we're using the pose-to-pose animation technique, I could set the keyframe at the end of the animation and essentially set up the animation, whatever I want the final pose to be, and something like this. Maybe this leg has turned. Try to grab this base, arms, turn the whole body, but he would still be looking at you. And this arm would be up in the air. And again, we use our elbow to rotate the arm around where we want it. This is not, I'm just showing you what the final pose might look like. So then we go in between all of these and have our handle. Have our final pose. Whoa. So we'll go ahead and undo all that. Go back to our starting position. So we already have our first keyframe. You can see by this yellow line. Our first keyframe is done. We lock the location, rotation, and scale of every bone in the scene. So now I've got my handle selected for my leg. Just kind of raise it up a little bit. Bring this. Maybe not quite that far. I have Blender animating at 24 frames per second. So figure how long it would be. I'm on about the 30th frame here. So I can actually go back. You know, imagine how long it would, what portion of turning around you would have done in a second. And kind of set up that pose. We'll spread it out so it'll be kind of slow at first. And then all I have to do is mark the location of these two bones. And we can watch them. Let me make this a little shorter. Stop it at 30. Oops. So there we go. So then I could go back to this keyframe. This arm would actually be back here behind the leg. His body would have turned at least a little bit to follow and indicate the motion. This hand would actually be back here behind the leg. Rotate the arm a little bit. rotate the hand around. So it's actually facing the right way. Bring this back. So then I would have this handle selected for the arm, my knee, my handle for the foot, my hand, my forearm, because I did do some rotation, and because there's so much and you don't want to try to keep track of everything, just put the data for location, rotation, and scale so you don't miss anything. I'm gonna keep working on this and probably do like a speed through, because it might take me a minute, because again I am learning this in real time as I'm recording.